Hi, I'm Rio Small. Alternative energy is important for everyone's future, from scientists to business people to anyone who uses electricity. Our society consumes huge quantities of fossil fuels to fulfill our energy needs. At our current rate, we will deplete our scarce resources and overheat our planet unless we find other sources of energy and fast. One of the most promising options is solar energy. Unlike fossil fuels, sunlight is free, abundant, and sustainable, and can be converted directly into electricity by solar cells. The first generation solar cells are silicon solar cells, formed from thin silicon wafers that act as a semiconductor, transporting electrons excited by light through an electric field. Silicon solar cells are relatively efficient and reliable, yet the silicon wafers are expensive to make and purify, and the resulting cell is rigid and brittle. In recent years, research has produced a dye-sensitized solar cell that uses organic dye instead of silicon to absorb light and initiate the flow of electrons. The dye is similar to the bright green chlorophyll plants use to make food from sunlight. The cells are inexpensive to make and can be bendable and thin, for they're not as efficient as silicon cells and dry out when exposed to air and sun. An ideal solar cell would be efficient, reliable, cost-effective, and flexible. Further research will develop third-generation solar cells that combine the best of silicon and dye-sensitized cells. This lab shows how to make a simple dye-sensitized solar cell using, of all things, berry juice to capture light and initiate the flow of electrons. The cell takes about 3 hours to assemble and will produce about 0.4 volts of electricity. This experiment shows how easy it is to mimic photosynthesis by using a natural dye to capture sunlight and convert it to energy in a form we can use.